Good morning, boys and girls, Mrs. Morehard. And today we are talking about fractions. And our learning target is I can tell how fractions are alike, the same, and how they are different. And in one of our previous videos, we looked at how you could use a fraction strip to compare your fractions, okay? So I want to show you an easy way to know whether one fraction is larger or smaller than another one. If we are going to have a number like this, one is our numerator out of five, and if we are going to have a fraction like this, one out of two being our denominator, how are we going to know which one is smaller and which one is larger? Well, let's go back to something that you're used to, whether it's a cake, pie, an apple, orange, something that you might eat, a sandwich. So you've got lots of examples around you about fractions. And of course, if you think about your cake, and if your parents cut that cake into five pieces and you get a piece, your piece is going to be smaller than if your parents went and cut the cake right in half. Half of that cake is going to be more than one-fifth of the cake. So the trick here is the larger the denominator is, that just means the more pieces something's been cut up to share. So let's think about, say, a fruit roll-up. If you were going to share that fruit roll-up with one other friend and you unrolled it, cut it right in the middle, you have a pretty big piece still, right? If you had six friends and you took it, hands were washed, of course, right? And you unroll it and you cut it into six equal bits, well, that piece is going to be smaller. So the more pieces that you have to make out of something, the smaller those pieces are. You can do that with a piece of paper. You can take the paper, fold it in half and cut it. Or you can take another piece of paper and you can fold it into, say, eighths and cut it. And you can see right there that the more pieces you cut it into, the smaller those pieces are. So a little bit of awareness around that when you are doing your fraction work, right? So thank you, boys and girls, for watching, and I hope you're going to look around your house for some more fractions that you can create. Maybe you're going to use your Lego. I'm not sure what you're going to do. Let me know when I talk to you next time. Bye for now.